Today, as part of this talk, we are going to discuss an awesome pairing technique that is promiscuous pairing. We'll get into the detail about what exactly the promiscuous pairing is, how it is different from our traditional pairing practices that we have been using as an agile practice, or sorry, XP practices for a long. Along with that, we'll get into the details of what is the beginner's mind, how we can leverage it. While getting into the details of that, we'll also walk through that how exactly we were able to adopt it, what are the challenges that we have faced, and what was the final outcome that we have gained out of it. So before I do that, let me just quickly brief you about myself. I am Ankur. I'm working with the JP Morgan as an agile developer, and I have spent like 12 years into the industry on to various product developments, into the financial as well as into the telecom. In my current role, I'm an agile developer working with a cross-functional feature team. Now, what does the cross-functional feature team means is the team is able to hold all the various flavor that is needed. So be it a QA, be it a development, be it the your requirements, everything is handled by the same team. And it's end-to-end feature team. That means it takes care of implementing the feature end-to-end, whatever it takes. Cutting cross across multiple components, products, layers, everything. It's not that we were not agile before, and this is something with which we tried to get into the agile mode. We have been agile for a pretty decent time, and it's been over a 1.5 year. And this background is necessary to understand when we'll get into the details about how the promiscuous pairing effectively works. Why you need to have that well-gelled team where you can actually trust and you can that comfortably pair with them. As part of our experiments, we keep on doing various XP practices experiments. Some work, some doesn't. We picked up as this promiscuous pairing is one of our experiments. I think I already covered that, but just to give you more gist around it, so though we are cross-functional and feature team, we work into the banking domain, so the domain itself is pretty complex. So that's a very interesting jigsaw, right? So we are talking about the bank, so certainly it's a highly regulated environment. It's not like whatever you want to do, you can do. Again, now it's a cross-functional feature teams and building feature end-to-end and doing that throughout every time. So by the way, before I get into the promiscuous pairing, how many of you have actually practiced the pair programming ever before? Okay. So for the benefit of the larger audience, let me just quickly spend a minute on this, what the pair programming is about. Pair programming is when two programmers work together on the same workstation.